And welcome back to Eyewitness News on the KSCW. 436-1212 is the number to call if you have a question for Attorney Charlie O'Hara. He joins us this morning and here to take your calls. Charlie, we got him lined up for you already, so let's get right to it.
Okay?
All right, go ahead, caller. You have a question for Charlie this morning. Go ahead. Caller, you're live on the air. Go ahead with your question for Charlie O'Hara, please.
Oh, yes. Recently, back in 2009, I was arrested in Arkansas while I was down there working. They said I broke into a house and stole a TV anyway. All of a sudden, they just decided to drop the charges here about 2 months ago. And I still had just about $5,000 bond and $1,500 lawyer and free trips back to Arkansas, time off work. Just wondering if any kind of motion I can file to give me any of that money back.
The quick answer to that is no. I mean, the reason you made a bond was so you could get out of jail. That was your own decision. The reason you hired an attorney was so you could be represented and hopefully the case could be dismissed, which it was. You decided to do that. Those are things that you did because there were charges against you. In a civil lawsuit, sometimes you can sue if somebody does something to you and they shouldn't have sued you. And sometimes you can go back for bad or malicious judgment. But in a criminal case, normally, I guess there's exceptions to everything, but normally speaking, there's nothing you can do. You're out the money, you got to be happy you don't have any charges. I think that'd be the thing I'd be right now, not worrying about the money.
Yeah. It's an interesting dilemma, though. I mean, it certainly doesn't seem fair if you didn't end up getting charged even with the crime and it couldn't stick.
Well, I always say to people they need to understand about the law is not always fair, but there's rules about how it works, and you have to follow the rules.
All right. Okay. Let's get to another call for Charlie. Go ahead, please call your question for Charlie O'Hara today.
Yeah, we're going to leave town for a couple of weeks and leave our teenage son with the grandma. We're just wondering if the medical power of attorney would be a wise thing to get, and also, do we need that as parents once he turns 18?
Well, I don't really... I think you can get it, and a lot of people do that. I think with technology today, if something happens, there's probably a way to do a lot of things unless you're somewhere that has no communications whatsoever. I mean, obviously, you could fax something or email something and get it right back and go to some place where you could do that. So usually you don't need to do that, but if you really want to be careful, it's probably a good idea. But I don't think you have to do it in today's world.
Okay. Okay? We got time, Charlie, to get another one in. So go ahead, please call your question for Attorney Charlie O'Hara today.
Yes, I fell under the Senate Bill 123 on the driving, and I was wondering if there's any way that a man can still get his driver's license back or not.
Well, and I'd have to know the exact specifics of your case, but they actually changed the law here recently, and usually, in most cases, you can get a license back. Now, you're going to have the machine in your car. We have to blow into it so that they know that you're not drinking when you drive it, and you're probably going to have that for quite a period of time. But I think the legislature's decided that to restrict people from not having any license ever is really prohibitive of them, at least in Kansas, having any employment. So I would think, and I have to check your specifics, you probably need to talk to somebody about that. I think you can usually get your license back 45 days with all the restrictions on it, which include blowing in the machine to drive.
Okay. All right, good answer, Charlie. Thank you so much for coming on. Appreciate it. And thanks for your phone calls today as well.